this year I was in Albuquerque with a gathering of clergy, a retreat of sorts, a training of sorts. Late one night, about five of us were fellowshipping and talking, and one person in the group asked us to share our most memorable moment when we were in public with our collar on and someone said something to us based upon our collar. And it went pretty much the way you would expect. There were some really poignant memories shared. There were funny memories shared. There were sad memories shared. I think probably the typical ones we've experienced, maybe if you're out and confronted by a very angry atheist, that came up. Or if you're just out in public at a restaurant and somebody approaches you and so earnestly asks for prayer, or sweetly prayer for someone they love, or sweetly and slightly weirdly prayer for their dog. Those came up. But I think maybe at the table I might have, if it were a contest, I might have won. At least based upon the laughter and the conversation that followed. I was at a coffee shop here in Memphis, and I was at the pump pot pumping the coffee into my cup when I felt a presence over my left shoulder. And I kind of went like this, and a gentleman I'd never seen before, never talked to before, whispered into my ear, "The Shroud of Turin has AB blood type." And then he just backed away and disappeared into the crowd. And I'm standing there with my coffee going, okay, that is interesting. It's interesting for, I guess, two reasons. One, as I understand it, AB is the universal receiver, which is a nice thought, but a different sermon. It's interesting to me because it does remind us, and it reminded me at that moment, and it, I hope, can further add meaning to your Lenten season, that what is central to our faith is the cross. Now, the cross is not the only thing central to our faith. We confess the atoning life, death, and resurrection is our salvation, but the cross is central to our faith. This is why St. Paul can say in the same breath, we are justified by faith in Christ. We are made right with God by faith in Christ, and then later in the same breath, in the same paragraph, say it a different way. We are justified. We are made right with God by Jesus' blood. This good news that God in and through Christ absorbed all of the brokenness and sin of the world directly the worst forms of it. But even as he was talking to the lady at the well, and she said, he knew everything about my past. That's a reminder to us that Jesus knows everything about us and yet still sits with us and receives from us and loves us. It is a beautiful, profound, humbling thought that by faith we inherit, the hope that Christ earned by Christ's faithfulness, the sufferings that led to endurance, that led to confirming the character of perfect faithfulness and trust in God the Father, that we can inherit that hope. It's by faith we confess and repent and trust in that grace, that access to God that is ours in and through Christ. I think after the intensity of this week, the good word is that by faith in Christ, we have peace with God, and we have hope that even now, as we feel like we are in the wilderness of sin, and we are thirsty, and we are worried, and we are anxious, that we can also follow Christ and know that God is already there, that God has gone before us, that God will meet us at the rock, that God will there perform miracles, that God will there bless us. I love the Old Testament lesson because it reminds me that we can be honest about our fears and anxieties, and yet also still follow Moses and the elders, trusting that God is there. And at the end of this journey, God is there already. That in effect, we, by faith, not only receive grace through the cross of Christ, but we commit our lives to love others in the same way that Christ loves us. We get a blessed opportunity to become what we already are. This week is a reminder, and the events today and ongoing will be a reminder to us of what we already know. And sometimes we forget, but we know. Every single day is a gift. Every single day is a gift. And so as it's been said, and as I've heard it said from the altar as a blessing, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those we journey with. So be swift to love. Make haste to be kind, and with courage and compassion, let us all commit our lives anew to following Christ. Amen.